What's going on, guys?
What's up? What's going on?
Yo, yo, what is going on? We are back. It feels like forever.
Honestly, it feels like it's been like a century since I've seen you guys. What's going on?
Well, it has been.
Not much.
We're going to do something a little different today, though. And we talked about this. We're going to flip it and continue something that's a little bit of a comparison, but more on a theme. So we're going to take songs. We're going to take two songs that share the same beat, hip-hop songs. And then we're going to compare. Clearly, it's the same beat, so we can't compare the beat. But the lyrics, and I would say even the impact, because these songs are both sort of like iconic and classic in different coasts and different times. But we want to talk about like which one of the two songs do we think had the most impact? And quite frankly, like who came out on top in terms of the usage of the beat? So we good with that?
I'm good with that. Let's get it cracking.
All right. So the songs that we're going to compare is Twinz from Big Pun and Fat Joe, featuring Fat Joe, and then Deep Cover with Snoop and Dre. Now, as we know, Twinz is basically a cover of the Deep Cover. All right, so we're going to start in timeline order. Let's turn it now to Snoop Dogg and Dre with Deep Cover.
Say, man, hit this.
No, man, I can't fade that.
Say, man, I've been dealing with you for 3 months. What's this all about? You ain't hit the pipe yet.
Yeah? That's what you're saying.
Might be 5-0.
Man, I ain't no police.
And what's the problem? Hit this. I can feel it.
Tonight's the night I get in some shit.
Yeah.
Deep cover on the incognito tip. Killing motherfuckers if I have to. Filling gaps too. Let your niggas know I'm coming at you. I guess that's part of the game. But I feel for the nigga who think he just gon' come and change things with the swiftness. So get it right with the quickness and let me handle my business. Yo, I'm on a mission and my mission won't stop until I get the nigga maxin' at the top.
I hope you get his ass before he drop.
Kingpin kicking back while his workers lay his rocks. Coming up like a fat rat. Big money, big cars, big bodyguards on his back. So it's difficult to get him.
But I got the hooker with somebody who knows how to get in contact with him.
Hit him like this and like that. Let him know that I'm looking for a big fat dope sack. What is the spin? So let's rush it. If you wanna handle it tonight, we'll discuss it. On a nigga's time and a nigga's place. Take my strap just in case one of his boys recognize my face. Cause he's a shiesty motherfucker. But I give a fuck, cause I'm going deep cover. Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on a undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on a undercover car. Creep with me as I crawl through the hood. Maniac lunatic calling Snoop Eastwood. Kicking dust as I bust fuck piece. And the motherfucking truck police. You already know I give a fuck about a cop. So why in the fuck would you think that it would stop? Plot, yeah, that's what we's about to do. Take your ass on a mission with the boys in blue. Dre,
what up, Snoop?
Yo, I got the feeling tonight's the night like Betty Wright. And I'm chilling, killing, feeling no remorse, yeah. So let's go straight to the motherfucking source and see what we can find. Crooked ass cops that be getting niggas a gang of time. And now they wanna make a deal with me. Scoop me up and put me on their team and chill with me. And make my pockets bigger. They wanna meet with me tonight at 7 o'clock.
So what's up, nigga?
What you wanna do?
What you wanna do?
I got the gauge of Uzi and my motherfucking 22. So if you wanna blast, nigga, we can buck them. If we stick them, then we stuck them. So fuck.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on a undercover car.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on a undercover car. 6:05 was the time on the clock when me and my homie bailed in the parking lot. The scene looked strange and it felt like a setup.
Better not be, cause if it is, they getting lit up.
Oh, here they come from the back and they lax. I'm checking for the gas, they strap. So what's up, black?
Chill, let's hit a deal. If it ain't up to what you feel, then grab your steel.
Right, so what you motherfuckers gon' come at me with? Hope you ain't wanting none of my grip, cause you can say that shit.
Guess what they told me?
We give you 20 G's if you snitch on your homie. We'll put you in a home and make your life plush. Oh yeah, but you gotta sell dope for us. Let me think about it. Turn my back and grab my gat, and guess what I told him before I shot it? If you don't quit, yeah. If you don't stop, yeah. I'm letting my gat pop, cause it's 187 on an undercover cop.
Yeah, and you don't stop,
cause it's 187 on an undercover cop.
Yeah, and you don't stop,
cause it's 187 on an undercover cop.
Yeah, and you don't stop,
cause it's 187 on an undercover cop.
Yeah, and you don't stop,
cause it's 187 on an undercover cop.
Yeah, and you don't
All right.
stop.
I gotta say, it's been quite a few years since I heard that song sort of beginning to end and listened to it. I mean,
same.
It's same. Iconic. It has so many lines that people just use. I mean, it became part of, you know, the lexicon, right? Like, it's so many one-liners here that just became just classics. Snoop's delivery, I mean, of course, Dr. Dre, but Snoop just absolutely, you know, established the song, you know, it was all, you know, from my perspective, all him, and it was just the storyline, the way he flowed, just his voice also, right? Because that's one of the things, it's just his melodic voice. It still is extremely iconic in so many lines. To your point, like, you forget how many lines he had that people in the hood and throughout the culture were just using for years.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, I thought, you know, Dre, you know, his verse, whatever, but he made the beat, right? So it's kind of like, you got to give, I mean, Dre is such a creative genius. What he said was pretty pedestrian in my opinion, but Snoop is just amazing. And it is such a ridiculously good beat for the moment, right? Because it was part of the Deep Cover movie. You could feel like you're undercover. Like, you could feel like there's something going on by just listening to that beat. It's kind of wild.
I had so many years I had not heard that song that I'm going to just wait till I hear the next one before I give my opinion. So whenever y'all ready, let's kick into the next version.
That's smart. Because now we're going to jump into something that's a little more, I say, you know, down our fairway, because this is East Coast, right? And clearly Fat Joe from the Bronx, we're all from the Bronx, and Big Pun. So this is one that's going to be near and dear to us. But let's take a listen to Big Pun featuring Fat Joe and Twinz and see how it compares.
I'm beating the crap out of the guy, you know what I mean, Twinz?
Yeah, yeah.
Part of the club, you know, not remembering who I am, you know what I mean? I'm trying to back him down, you know what I mean? They're not trying to hear it. Hello? Say, no, come on fast.
Hey, yo, Big Pun, it looks like you got a snitch in your camp, you hear me?
Ready for war, Joe, how you wanna blow they spot? I know these dirty cops that'll get us in if we so hop in your Hummer, the punish is ready. Meet me and Beatles with noodles, we'll do this do while he's slurping spaghetti. Everybody kiss the floor, don't be cracked. More if they move, noodles that dead in the middle of little did we know that we riddled a middleman who didn't do diddly. It'll be a cold day and hell the day I take it now. Make no mistake, for real, I wouldn't hesitate to I'm still a fat one that you love to hate. Catch you at your mother's wake. Then I you whip my your face off the earth and family, children like Amityville, and drill the nerves in your cavity, filling insanity's building a pavilion in my civilian. It can't be the anarchy that humanity's filling. A villain without remorse who's willing to out your boss forever and take all the cheddar like child support.
I support punning anything he does, anything he loves.
A brother from another mother sent for the above. A duck just like me, one of the best might be. Even better, leave it kneeling on a right knee. Spike Lee couldn't paint a better picture. You small change, I'm got your brains getting richer. With them smacking, what you get stuck? My fingers into your truck jewels. Cruising in the land, pumping cash rules. Last crew to want it, caught 100 trying to pass through.
That's true.
So who the next
to get it. T.S. the best that did it. Get it off your chest, get admitted. And it's yeah, and you don't stop. 20 with the cop, thriller to the top. Yeah, and you don't stop. Joey the rock and Big Pun keeps the cock. Yeah, and you don't stop. We'll make it hot. Why bring it up on your whole spot? Yeah, and you don't stop. It's still 187 on the police are first making knee third, taking feet first through the morgue, then launch them in the deep earth. The streets curse, the First Amendment's culturally biased. Supposed to supply us with rights tonight. I hold my rosary tight as I can. I'm one man against the world, just me and my girl, black pearl, Athena, my Sfina. But keeps it real, you know the deal. We steal from the rich and keep it peeping. It's no secret. Watch me and Joe go back and forth and freak.
Creep with me as I cruise in my Beamer. All the kids in the ghetto call me Don Cartagena, kicking off heat. And you never see me talk to police. No, you should know that I really don't care. Whoop by the hair, then I leave you right there. So beware, it's red. One beat, with blunt speak, and let these know how we run the streets.
I run the streets deep with no compassion. Puerto Ricans known for watching while they sleeping, no relaxing. Keep your eyes open, sharp reflexes. Three Texas in the Jeep Lexus, just in case police testers. Street professors, several squad, ghetto scholars, full of up, inflicts the free regard when the metal hollers. Better acknowledge your down until I'm locked and shot down. Have to be, couldn't make me put my down.
We locked down fake rounds in the chamber, boogie down major like nine. Mine every time, plus I'm the crime boss of New York. When we taught to walk the walk, on my carry chalk and stalk, I pray like a predator. Whoever want it, go and get it, set it, baby, and I'ma bury ya. So remember the squad that I'm reppin', I'm full of my weapon, punish, running, still is Armageddon. Yeah, and you don't stop.
20 with the cop, fill up to the top.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
Joey cracks the rock, and Big Pun keeps the hot.
Yeah, and you don't stop.
We'll make it hot. Why bring it up on your whole spot?
Yeah, and you don't stop.
It's still 187 on the
yeah, and you don't stop.
Wake up, stupid. That's what you get for yapping your mouth. Danny.
And I gotta say, bro, you say like when we're doing a comparison like this, right? Since we're using the same beat, we can't use that as part of the criteria. And the chorus, right? They recycled portions of the original chorus, and credit where credit is due to both both Dre and Snoop. But when it comes to just pure lyricism and the athleticism behind the delivery on Deep Cover, on the Twinz remix, I gotta give it to that song. While understanding the cultural impact that the original had throughout hip-hop, you know, this didn't have that cultural impact. I think, you know, there's a little bit of bias in me because I'm from New York, because I'm from the Bronx and the East Coast, but when it comes to just the lyrical athleticism that these guys displayed in 98, it just hits different for me personally. That's just where I'm at. Where are you guys at with everything?
I mean, Big Pun.
It's complicated.
Well, it's not even, to me, I think the impact of the original, the delivery from Snoop, there's so many unquestionable things, but what Big Pun did to this beat, and you know, and credit to Joe, because even though Joe didn't keep up with Big Pun, I thought Joe delivered a punchier thing than like Dre did on his side, right? Like if we're talking about like the duo, like I thought Joe held his half more than Dre. But it's really
hard. He punched a lot higher above his weight class than Dre did for sure.
I mean, if you, it's like fuck the police. I squeeze first, make them eat dirt, take the feet first through the morgue, then lodge them in the deep earth. The streets is cursed. The First Amendment is culturally biased. Supposed to supply us with rights. Tonight, I hold my rosary tight as I can. So this dude just in that, just there's so many words in like four lines. It is so ridiculous. And to me, it's just way more, for as an East Coaster, it's just way more East Coast punchy. You know, like I feel like Deep Cover, yeah, the original one, is like a mellow kind of like, and they stay with that which by the way is fantastic. Like I could listen to that song all the time, and
of course,
but this is more like, okay, we're gonna battle. This is like, all right, like something's happening here. And Big Pun, just the amount of the mastery of the English language and the ability to compact so many words into like lines, I mean, it's pretty ridiculous. There's a reason why most of us Latinos can say dead in the middle of Little Italy. Little did we know that we riddled some little men who didn't do diddly. There's a reason why we could say that basically without thinking. It's because this is so iconic.
They also had the benefit of building on an iconic beat, right? So that also. But they, you know, they obviously the main elements were already there, right? So they had that to their advantage. It's just a different song, but if you're going to compare lyricists, I mean, Big Pun, this is probably, I don't know, another song where he dropped better lyrics, better bars. I mean, this is masterful, and I think it's because they knew, right? They knew the pressure. Like, when you're going to take that beat and you're going to actually go mainstream with it, you know, I think that they understood they had a hit, because you just wouldn't do that. That's a career, like, you know, if you want to end someone's career quick, take an iconic beat like that has so much cultural significance, and screw it up, right? Do that, you're over, right?
Yeah. You
know, I think they understood the stakes were high. Sure. Like, you're taking a cultural iconic beat and saying, I'm going to flow on it. And you got to have the guts to do it. And I think that they did it masterfully. And when they went back and forth, it wasn't like the lyric, it was just their flow. There was just some synergy to their exchange that was really, you know, really, it felt genuine. It felt like they were almost like a group, and they weren't, right?
Yeah, and it's funny what you said, because it's clear that, like, Joe and Pun, they later took the song and they were like, okay, how am I going to build, right? Because if you see Snoop, he's like, creep with me as I crawl through the hood, maniac, lunatic, call me Snoop, Eastwood, kicking dust as I bust, fuck peace, and the motherfucking punk police, right? But then, you know, Joe said, you know, creep with me as I cruise in my Bimo, all the kids in the ghetto call me Don Carter Gina, kicking ass
call
as I
buzz Don Carter Gina,
and you never see me talk to police. So it's like literally like the same bars, but, you know, Snoop was like,
it
flipped different, because it's way more, again, it's way more battle.
Yeah,
so it's like, you
definitely
got like battle, Bronx, let's go, versus, like, you know, Snoop, which is more like relaxed, kind of like, hey, I'm just cool. And it's funny, you know, Snoop looks so young, particularly in that scene when they're like in the car, he has a suit, he looks like he's like a 10-year-old. And it really speaks to the longevity of the greats, right? Like Snoop and Dre, like, they're still doing stuff, right? Snoop, not that much lately, but, you know, Dre continues and Joe's still around, right? And it's kind of like these really iconic people. This is 1994, 1998, right?
Wow, man.
We're talking 30 years ago, and these dudes are still here. And Pun would have still been here had he been alive as one of the greats and continue to make music. And it's incredible to see how the people that are like as creative as these folks are destined to make a lot of money, because all three of the people that are still alive are pretty rich, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's just that ability to stay relevant, that ability to create new music. Clearly, Dre is the most creative out of the three, because he's done so much just with music and production.
Of course.
And again, you know, I'm pretty sure that Dre sees, like, when he hears words, it's like colors, right? And when he sees colors, it's like smells. You know what I mean? Like these like crazy creative types that could just flip things around. Snoop is just Snoop, just one of the smoothest human beings ever born. And then Don Cartagena, like that, he's just came out the hood, bootstrapped. So it's great to see these two songs. I really enjoy them. I think if we got to pick one song, though, to say which is the top, because we've been very complimentary so far. Everybody's like compliment showers.
No, look, I think if I had to keep one on my playlist, and I can only keep one on my playlist, I'm going to go with the Twinz version. You know, it's the same beat, a lot of the same chorus, but from a content perspective, when it comes to the bars and just the verses, I think that I find myself more entertained and more amused with Fat Joe and Big Pun over Dre and Snoop, because Snoop clearly carries the original version. Here, there is, you know, you can see that Pun carries it, but it's not as drastic as the carry that Snoop did for Dre, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. Ken, what about you? If you got to take one off your playlist, keep one, which one you keep in, which one you taking off?
Yeah, same, you know, and I think it's because they really played, remember, they were writing that song for that movie, right? So, like, there's a certain element about that that I think, again, it was an advantage that Pun and Fat Joe had. They were just like, what's the most relevant thing I want to write about, right? Let me kill it. I think that these guys had to sort of go with the plot, right? And if you see Snoop's verse, it's very much, right? And you saw in the video, it kind of like, it goes with that. So yeah, if I have to keep one in the playlist, it's gonna be, you know, Twinz. It's just the tempo, the beat is a little faster, right? There's more lyrics. There's more dynamic to it. You could really bop to it. You know, I definitely would go with that. But, you know, you got to respect the classics, you know?
Yeah, I'm on the same boat with you guys. Respect the classics for sure. If Deep Cover comes on like a random thing on Spotify or whatever, I'm not going to hit forward. I'm going to listen to the song. It's a classic song. I enjoy the song. But if I got to keep one in my playlist now, it'll definitely be Twinz because... most, you know, it has like a different flow to it. It has a different energy to it, which, you know, you kind of need sometimes when you're listening to, like, you know, the songs that are like 30 years old, like which mood. Like I could put Twinz in like a workout playlist, for example, right? I could have Twinz in my walking thing, and quite frankly, like, you can always just be mesmerized by, you know, the lyrical genius of Big Pun in this particular song. I mean, I think Big Pun was a genius in way more than this song, but this song, it just highlighted it so much because, again, because there was so much around the usage of the beat and whatnot. And I do think that they did it well. I thought they did it respectfully. And I thought, again, I don't mind, you know, Joe's verses. I thought Joe
represented.
I think
he held his own. It's just
Joe held his own.
It's just Punt went crazy. It was like, you know, like,
yeah, exactly.
It's like, you know, if someone comes out, they shoot. You know, they shoot the best night of their life. You know, triple double, and their teammate, you know, scores 80. I don't know. You know, it's like, you did great, son. But this guy right here, just, you know, it was a phenomenal performance. And I think, again, I think they did it right, and I think that they, you know, were intentional and really, really cognizant of the fact that of the cultural implications of using that beat.
Yeah, I agree with that for sure. Well, this was fun. I mean, it's good. It actually resurfaced these songs for me, to be honest. Particularly Deep Cover, because I do listen to Twinz once in a while, but Deep Cover I really hadn't listened to in a while. And although I don't think it's gonna, you know, overtake Twinz, I definitely think it's coming back on my rotation because I do enjoy the song a lot. But this was a fun one. We gotta do more like these where we're like just comparing and contrasting.
Definitely.
Similar
beats, different discovery.
Similar themes.
Yeah.
All right. Well, look, this was fun. We're gonna have to pick more songs or more comparisons like this to hopefully resurface some classic songs back to the rotation and then just do a comparison to who has doing. I have fun. Hope you guys have fun too.
This was good. This was good. And it, you know, again.
So this was definitely fun. Like doing these. It's a good way to go about it.
All right.
Peace.
All right. Later, guys.
Later. Come on.